Okay, so today we're going to talk about bias reporting systems, which are just the latest way universities have handed campuses over to their most ridiculous students. So over the past couple of years, hundreds of schools have set up systems where students can anonymously narc on each other for offending their delicate sensibilities. These so-called bias response teams encourage campus community members to anonymously rat each other out for alleged incidents of bias or hate speech. What these systems actually do is turn campuses into surveillance states where any politically incorrect utterance in a private conversation can earn a student or professor a visit from a diversity counselor after a complaint is made. The anonymous complaint can end up in a student or professor's permanent file, affecting their future ability to get jobs. So this is like putting your future in the hands of a YouTube comment section. And of course, when bias is in the eye of the beholder, all sorts of ridiculous complaints can be lodged. For instance, in the fall of 2018, a student at the University of Utah complained about an outdoor group holding a Hawaiian shirt night, saying it was insensitive to the school's Hawaiian and Pacific Islander population. A Michigan State student reported his dorm roommate for watching a video featuring conservative commentator Ben Shapiro. The student was given the option of finding a new roommate. At the University of Wisconsin, one male student was reported for hogging weights at the campus gym. A female student said he was exhibiting, quote, toxic masculinity. And these go on and on and on. A Portland State student was reported for joking about being schizophrenic. A Michigan State student was triggered by seeing an abandoned game of hangman left on a campus dry erase board. A group of male Virginia Tech students earned a reprimand for suggesting in a private conversation that female students weren't very good at throwing snowballs. University administrators who like bias reporting systems say they're no big deal because they don't literally rush into classrooms and prevent people from speaking. But the idea of being hauled before a university panel to explain yourself or being threatened with a mark on your permanent record is enough to keep people from making off-color jokes or expressing their more traditional opinions. At the University of Illinois, a campus law enforcement officer actually sits on the bias team's board, making it a literal speech police. In the past year, Illinois has seen numerous complaints from students offended by a campus group that wants to bring back their Native American mascot, Chief Illiniwek. The problem with bias systems is that there are no rules that determine whether something is legitimately over the line. The standard is set solely with the person who's offended, and that could be anything from a smirk to an eye roll. In fact, if you're watching this video in a college dorm room right now, you might be getting a call from a diversity officer any minute. Further, the fact that complaints can be filed anonymously just invites mischief from students looking to settle scores with other students they dislike or professors that gave them a bad grade. As Oscar Wilde once said, give a man a mask and he'll tell you the truth. In 2019, it's more like give a student an anonymous email account and he'll probably report you to the diversity office for wearing a red MAGA hat.